It resonates in everyone's mind. It retains the mysterious beauty of its long history. And it has the masterpieces created by Mother Nature. And this is a story of Korean land and history. Korean classical musician Lee Kwang-soo guides us through Yesan, a place where tradition dwells. The sound of Samulnori rings throughout. This Samulnori school, which was built by renovating a closed school. This school was set up by Kwang-soo, who has worked hard to spread Korean classical music both within and outside the country.
Actually, it's just because I love this place and people are very kind and they have a huge experience of Korean traditional music. So I'm here in the essence of Samulnori and it's very interesting to be here.
Every year, many international visitors come here. This Japanese man, who is visually impaired, has been coming here for 8 years now. Kwang-soo decided to come home to help keep Korean classical music from disappearing from his hometown. Thanks to him, the sound of Samulnori rings throughout Yesan. We embark on the trip with Kwang-soo as our guide. Many artists and writers have been born in Yesan. Our first destination is the house of Chusa Kim Jung-hee, the writer and calligrapher from the Joseon era. Situated in a sunny area, the house has the structure of a classical scholar's house with a separate inner house and guest house. This is where Chusa was born and spent his childhood. The inner house has a practical structure that is square-shaped with a wide floor and doors and windows, well-fitted for their functions.
우리 한국 한옥 양식이 이게 명자집인데 이 안에 공명이 생겨요. 그러니까 요즘 서양 말로 하면 에코 현상이 생겨서 여기에서 작은 소리를 해도 이게 큰 소리로도 변하고 대청마루 같은 데서 이제 뭐 판소리를 한다든지 뭐 구슬을 한다든지 했을 때 엄청난 그 소리 그리고 육성으로 그게 전달이 됐고
Chusa is well known for his calligraphy. He left his mark on this house.
노지실이라. 안녕하세요. 이 다른 글씨체에 비해서는 특히 저 현판은 글씨체가 좀 많이 다르거든요.
좀 그렇죠. 모습이 좀 이렇게 좀 네. 다르죠?
It was a piece made for a friend who liked to drink tea.
이제 선비가 이렇게 방에다 화로를 놓고 거기에다 물을 끓이니까 물이 이렇게 모락모락 피어오르지 않습니까? 김이? 네. 네. 그런 모습을 이제 형성해가지고 가시자를 쓰셨어요. 네. 뭐 이렇게 피어오르는 것처럼. 그리고 집실자도 정말로 이렇게 창이 있는 그런 집의 모양을 형성해가지고.
Chusa always had his own original calligraphic style. For a long time, this house has preserved the legacy of Chusa. This man breathes new life into the letters of Chusa. Hakyu hopes to celebrate the spirit of Chusa who grew up in Yesan by carving his calligraphy out of wood. The letters of Chusa represent his life.
아기들이 쓴 글씨 같으면서도 이 짜임새가 잘 짜여져 있어. 짜임새가. 그러니까 그만큼 이 글씨에 대해서 모든 걸 터득했다는 얘기. 통달했으니까 이런 글씨체도 쓴다는
Chusa created many different original fonts and came up with radical characters that made use of various features.
안녕하세요.
네. 아, 안녕하세요. 반갑습니다. 네,
반갑습니다.
예. 이거는 이제 무량수인데.
예, 예.
일반인들이 읽을 때는 다 천량수로 많이 읽었나요?
예. 예.
그 추사 선생만 이 무자를 이런 식으로 많이 썼어요. 다른 서예가들은 이런 무자를 잘 안 써. 아니면 이게 구부러져서 올라가서 없을 무자가 됩니다.
He also made pieces that were pictorial.
저런 코끼리 상자도 봐. 코끼리 상자도 코끼리 마냥 똑같이 이렇게 그려놨어요. 네. 지금 사람들도 상상을 못하는 걸 그때 당시에 상상을 해서 이렇게 짜임새 있게 다 해놨어요. 그러니까 여백을 잘 살리면서 추사 네. 선생님의 글씨는 그 짜임새가 아주 차가워요.
Hakyu does not gain much recognition for what he has been doing, but he keeps at it nonetheless.
누가 해도 해야 할 거 아니에요. 네. 누가 지켜도 지켜야 돼.
누가 해도 확인해야 돼. 네. 예.
누가 알아주고 알아주는 건 안 알아주는 건 나중에 후세에 가서 판명이 날 것이고 그래서 끝까지 한번 해보는 데까지 해보자 하는 거.
하여튼 훌륭하십니다.
Although not as tall, Deoksung Mountain is called the Geumgang of Hoseo. Deep in the heart of the mountain lies the Sudok Temple. Sudok Temple is thought to have been first built during the era of Three Kingdoms under Baekje and repaired during the Goryeo period. The temple sits snugly amongst the hills of Deoksung Mountain. In the midst of it is the National Treasure No. 49, the Daeungjeon. An example of wooden architecture from the Goryeo period, the spacious structure is in harmony with the doors of delicate patterns. It's a structure that has the Jushinpo style of Goryeo architecture, where the roof is supported by rows of wooden struts above the pillars. It is also a precious historical temple where intestine-style bulging pillars can be found.
무시 없이 나무와 나무를 끼워 맞춰서 이런 큰 건물을 지었다는 것과 대흘림 기둥, 해가 이렇게 조금 나온 대흘림 기둥이 양식의 맞대 지붕으로 되어 있는 고려 때의 건축물로 대한민국에서 가장 아름다운 녹조 건축물이라고 말씀드릴 수 있습니다.
네.
It is a precious cultural artifact that a thousand years of history has created.
(목소리) 어머니 품속 같고 그 편안함이 있는데 그 자체는 우선 산세가 험악하지 않고 우리 집보다도 편한 곳이다. 저는 그런 느낌을 가지고 가끔 들리곤 합니다.
It sometimes becomes a space that gives a sense of comfort, and sometimes it's a space to renew the mind and train oneself. around the corner from the Daeungjeon of Sudok Temple is the Sudok Inn. Sudok Inn is the place where painter Yung-lo expressed his artistic fervor. He began as an oriental painter and worked in other fields, including tapestry as well. He was influential not only in Korea, but all over the world. Sudok Inn was a refuge as well as an artistic space for him to put the regional scenery onto canvas. He is no longer here, but his artistic spirit remains.
Sanjung에 사는 예산입니다. 예산에 그 계란으로 얘기하면 노린자위 같은 곳인데 바로 충청도 양반 꼴 중에도 그 우직함이나 고지식함 그 정도라고 생각하면 가는 그런 정신을 가지고 오늘까지 온 겁니다.
The spirit of tradition dwells in Yesan. It has continued to do so for 1,000 years and will continue for the next 1,000.